I am Brother Matthew. Thank you for tuning in once again.
He will lift up Jesus ever.
Delivered by our General Superintendent, Pastor W.F. Kumoye.
I know that I've said, you know, Happy New Year. I said that on the first Sunday, and I said that on the second Sunday. This is my third Sunday in the year. And those who are listening to me and watching, they're wondering, if I say Happy New Year again, they'll say, but you said that the other time. You don't understand. We have, this is the first time I've seen these beautiful, wonderful faces here. And I say Happy New Year in Jesus' name. And I pray that this year, if you didn't know how to smile, I'll teach you how to smile. And how to laugh, because laughter has come this year. And the joy of the Lord will be your strength in Jesus' name. You know, this year when you begin to smile and begin to laugh, your enemies will forget themselves, they laugh with you. Laugh and let me see you. Praise the Lord. You know, I told you already that the year of happiness is a year of holiness. This year for us, for everyone in this church, and for every family, is going to be a year of what? A year of holiness. That spells out to mean that you are going to be honest, you are going to be humble, you are going to be obedient to the word of God. Every word I teach and every word our leaders teach, our coordinators, our pastors, our group coordinators, our overseers, every word we teach this year, you will obey. And you'll observe to do according to all that is written in the word. It will be a year of love and a year of living for Christ. A year of incorruptibility. Doctrine incorruptible. Conduct incorruptible. Life principle incorruptible. A year of being innocent. You'll be innocent from every form of sin. And then you'll be nurtured in the word of God. You'll be a new creature in Christ, a new name, a new nature, and a new lifestyle. Everything about us this year will be new in Jesus' name. This year, we will endure. He that endures to the end, the same shall be saved. And it's a year of excellence. You know, in the past, you do something and say, that's good enough, that's good enough. This year, our purpose, our goal is excellence in everything. A year of separation, a year of being set apart, and it's a year of sanctification. Everybody say sanctification. A year of sanctification, a year of sacrifice. We're not going to offer to anything to the Lord this year that costs us nothing. A year of self-denial. And I pray the Lord will accomplish it in every life in Jesus' name. Today we're looking at Hebrews chapter 11 verse 39 and verse 40. Hebrews chapter 11 verse 39. And these all, having obtained a good report through faith, received not the promise, God having provided some better thing for us, that they without us should not be made perfect. I want you to look at that word, better. This year is going to be better than any other year in your life. Yeah. That when you look at the end of this year, as if Jesus tarries, and then you look at what the Lord has done from January to December, in your family, in your life, in your business, in the church, in your own soul, in your own spirit, all around you, it's only one word you'll be able to use at the end of the year, that's the word, better. God having provided some better thing for us, that without us, they should not be made perfect. In fact, as you look at the epistle to the Hebrews, you'll find that word better and better and better coming up every time. We're looking at chapter 8, verse 6. Chapter 8 of Hebrews, verse 6. But now as he obtained a more excellent ministry, by how much also is the mediator of a better covenant, that's the word again, better covenant, which was established upon better promises. It's saying that yes, we had promises in the past, and we had provisions in the past, and we had all these things that God gave us in the past, but this year everything is going to be better. We're looking at Hebrews chapter 10, verse 34. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 34. For ye had compassion of me in my bones, and took joyfully the spoiling of your goods, knowing in yourselves that ye have in heaven a better and an enduring substance. It says that here on earth, better promises. And then when we eventually get to heaven, a better substance. We're looking at Hebrews chapter 11, verse 16. But now they desire a better country, that is an heavenly, whereof, wherefore God is not ashamed to be called their God, for he has prepared for them a city. Again, you find that word there, and it's talking of better. Everything about us this year, everything about the provision of the Lord is saying, is going to be better than it ever was in our lives in Jesus' name. Ezekiel chapter 36. Ezekiel chapter 36. We're reading from verse 9. For behold, I am for you, and I will turn unto you, and ye shall be tilled and sown, and I will multiply men upon you, all the house of Israel, even all of it, and the city shall be inhabited, and the ways shall be builded, and I will multiply upon you men, man and beast, and they shall increase and bring forth and bring fruit. And I will settle you after your old estates, and will do better unto you than all than at your beginnings. That is, since you became born again, you repented of your sin, you believed on the Lord Jesus Christ, you came to the Lord as your Lord and Savior, and your life turned around, and your life was transformed, and your life was changed, and you can tell a lot of testimonies since you became born again. The Lord has done this and this and this for me. At the beginning of my Christian life, the Lord is saying, whatever you've got in the past, you are going to get more. Whatever you have experienced in the past, you are going to experience more. And no matter how great and glorious the blessings of the Lord have been upon your life in the past years, it says, I will do better unto you than at your beginnings, and ye shall know that I am the Lord. Verse 23. In verse 23, I'm reading there, and it says, and I will sanctify my great name, which was profaned among the heathen, which ye have profaned in the midst of them, and the heathen shall know that I am the Lord, says the Lord God, when I shall be sanctified in you before their eyes. The Lord is saying that when people look at your life this year, they look at the blessings you have, they will glorify the name of the Lord. They will exalt the name of the Lord. They will sanctify the name of the Lord. In verse 24, for I will take you from among the heathen and gather you out of all the countries, which I will bring you into your own land. You will come to your own land. You will live in your own house. All this, the landlord coming and saying, where is the rent? Where is the rent? I'm telling you, for thousands of us this year, you get your own land. You get your own house. And then it will even be big enough, you rent it out to other people. And instead of people putting pressure on you, where is my rent? You'll be telling them, hey, come on here, where is my rent? It's going to happen. It's beginning to happen already. Verse 25, then will I sprinkle clean water upon you, and you shall be clean. This year, you'll be clean. In your soul, in your spirit, in your life, in your business, you'll be clean in Jesus' name. Every impurity, every iniquity, every idolatry, and everything that soils people, that defiles people, that makes people dirty, dirty in their conscience, dirty in their soul, dirty in their mind, all that the Lord will cleanse away. For I will cleanse, I will sprinkle clean water upon you, and you shall be clean from all your filthiness of all your idols will I cleanse you, and a new heart will I give unto you, and a new spirit will I put within you. We're going to have new hearts. Our children will have new hearts. Our teenagers will have new hearts. And our parents will not have heart attack over their children in Jesus' name. Running after them this way, they escape to that way, and we say, these children are supposed to be a blessing, but these children are giving me heart attack. Not this year. No hypertension this year. No heart attack this year. Because our youths, our children, our wives, our husbands, a new heart in Jesus' name. A new heart also will I give you, and a new spirit will I put within you, and I will take away. Everybody say, take away. When God takes it away, it will no more be there. In our sisters, God will take this away. In our brothers, God will take this away. Among our workers, God will take this away. God says, I will. God says, I will. He says, I will. He will do it. He says, I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh, and I will give you an heart of flesh. And I will put my spirit within you, and cause you to walk in my statutes, and you shall keep my judgments and do them. This year will be a congregation of doers. Not a congregation of just hearers. Hearing the word only will do the will of God. And you shall dwell in the land that I gave to your fathers. And you shall be my people, and I will be your God. And I will also save you from all your uncleannesses. And I will call for the corn, I will increase it, and lay no famine upon you. No famine this year. I will multiply the fruit of the tree and the increase of the field, that ye shall receive no more reproach of famine among the heathen. Verse 33, thus says the Lord God, in the day that I shall have cleansed you from all your iniquities, I will also cause you to dwell in the cities, and the ways shall be builded, and the desolate land shall be tilled, whereas it lay desolate in the sight of all that pass by. And they shall say, this land that was desolate is become like the garden of Eden. And the waste and the desolate and the ruined cities are become fenced and inhabited. Then the heathen that are left round about you shall know that I, the Lord, build the ruined places and plant that was desolate. I, the Lord, have spoken it, and I will do it. All the promises the Lord has given us this year of a better life, better family, better business, better progress, better flock, better church, better relationship, better blessing, better promises, everything the Lord said, I have spoken it, and will do it. In verse 37, thus says the Lord God, I will yet for this be inquired of by the house of Israel to do it for them. And I will increase them with men like a flock. The Lord is saying, He wants us to even still pray, even though He had promised us, even though He has said, this is what I will give, and this is what I will do. He says, and yet for all this my people are going to ask me. And it is in that asking Him and praying, the Lord is going to do everything for us. That means then, as we're expecting that this year will be a year of prosperity, then it will be a year of prayer. And every time as we're asking, the Lord will answer and give it unto us in Jesus' name. The topic I'm speaking about, God's promise of better things for all believers. God's promise of better things for all believers. Everyone here, there's no exception. This year is going to become better than any other year in our lives. 3 points we're considering. Number one, the gracious provision of better things. The gracious provision of better things. The gracious provision of better things. Those better things will come. And you find that by the grace of God, He has provided them. It's given by grace. It's not something you struggle for, something you fight for, something you run after. These blessings of better things will run after you this year. The gracious provision of better. Number two, the great power of bridled tongues. The great power of bridled tongues. How those things are going to come your way. How the better blessings and the better riches, the better miracles and the higher things are going to come in your life. It's through your tongue. And you bridle that tongue when it comes the time to withdraw the blessing, to bring the blessing upon your life. Then you open that mouth and blessings will fill your mouth. The great power of bridal tongues. Number three, the guarded promises, protected promises, guarded promises of blessed treasures. The guarded promises of blessed treasures. Number one, what's number one? The gracious provision of better things, all this for you. I said all this for you. In Isaiah chapter 56, verses 4 and 5. Isaiah chapter 56, verses 4 and 5. For thus says the Lord, unto the eunuchs that keep my Sabbath. He's talking to people that honor the Lord enough, respect the Lord enough, reverence the Lord enough, exalt the Lord enough in their lives, that they keep His word and they keep the Sabbaths. They keep the Lord's day holy. And they reverence the Lord, they honor the Lord, they worship the Lord on the Lord's day. And they make it a principle. Today is the day of the Lord. From the very time I wake up until the night, I'm just going to have all my heart, all my might centered on the Lord. The people that worship the Lord on His day, thus says the Lord, unto the eunuchs that keep my Sabbaths and choose the things that please me. The people that do not choose the things that please their flesh, please their families, please their neighbors, please their friends, or even please their enemies, or please anybody in their lives, but the number one person to please is the Almighty God. And they are asking themselves all the time, what I do, what I say, how I live, how I comport myself, does this please the Lord? They're not pleasing their carnal minds, because the carnal mind is taken away. The stony heart is taken away. All they want to do, they say, Lord, my commitment to you this year, my consecration to you this year, and my sacrifice this year will be to please you all the time. And he says, they choose the things that please me and take hold of my covenant. It says the two things that precede taking hold of the covenant blessing. It is number one, you want to honor the Lord on His day, on the day of the Lord, every Sunday. You want to make sure that all your heart, all your mind is given to the worship of the Lord and not to pleasure. And not to all these extramural studies and all these various things, but you say today is the day of the Lord, and the only one I recognize today, respect today, reverence today, worship today is the Lord. And then you choose the things that please Him every time.